In this fourth exercise, we are going to solve a problem that is related to a different molecule, which is an ionic compound. We have this data for KCl, which is an ionic compound, as we have said, and the first question is to represent the thermodynamic cycle or Born-Haber cycle that describes the formation of this ionic solid KCl through two different paths, the direct path and the indirect path. And the second question is to calculate the lattice energy of this crystalline solid. So here we have this equation. The formation of KCl from its element under standard states. For potassium, it is the solid state, and chlorine is the gaseous state, or Cl2, which gives KCl in solid state. To form the KCl, we have to go from these two substances. But here we have the standard or the formation of this KCl. It corresponds to this standard enthalpy of formation that we call delta HF for KCl. Now, to get the lattice energy, we have to move through a different path. So first, we have to change each substance to a gaseous state. So as the first step, we have to change these two substances in gaseous state and as isolated atom. So for potassium, we need to change it to potassium in gaseous state. We need an energy that is called the sublimation energy. So the sublimation energy is given here. We have, which is equal to 88 kilojoule per mole. And here we have chlorine. Here chlorine, we have a diatomic molecule. So we need to break this bond. So we need to provide the bond energy that corresponds to this bond, which is equal to delta H Cl Cl. But here we have half, and because it is here given as negative value, so we have to multiply by minus 1. Now we have Cl gas in atomic state. Now as a second step, we have to ionize both elements. To ionize the potassium, we need to provide an energy that is called the ionization energy of potassium to form the ionic potassium in gaseous state. And also to ionize the chlorine atom, we have to provide an energy that is called electron affinity of chlorine to form Cl minus in gaseous state. So this is the ionization energy. It is the energy that is needed to remove one electron from the potassium. And here we have the electron affinity of chlorine. It is the energy that is needed for the chlorine to accept one electron. Now that we have both gaseous atoms in their ionic state, we can form the KCl like this using the lattice energy. Here it is. Now, after having represented the Born-Haber cycle, now we apply the Hess law to determine this lattice energy. So we have the direct path. The standard enthalpy of formation of KCl is equal to the sum of all this energy involved in this cycle, which is equal to the sublimation of the potassium minus the bond energy of chlorine plus the ionization energy of potassium plus the electron affinity of chlorine plus the energy lattice of KCl. And all these values are given, and we'll calculate this lattice energy. Now we'll bring out this energy from this equation. Now, having the equation to calculate the lattice energy, we'll plug each value in this equation. And the final value of the energy lattice is equal to negative 716.6 kilojoules per mole. Now, for the second question, so we have in this case to calculate the standard enthalpy of formation of KBr from this equation. And we are given here all the value needed to calculate this standard enthalpy of formation. However, here we have the halogen in a liquid state, not in gaseous state. So here we first have to write the equation. We have the potassium in solid state plus bromine in liquid state, which gives the crystalline solid KBr in solid state. And here, as we can see, we have just first to change the substance in gaseous state. To go from potassium solid to the potassium gas, we need to provide an energy that is called the sublimation energy of potassium. And here, to move from bromine in liquid state to the bromine in gaseous state, we need to provide energy that is called the standard enthalpy of vaporization. Now, the bromine can be broken in two atoms. So we move still forward, and we have here the potassium in gaseous state plus, because here we have bromine with this Lewis structure, will break out this bond by providing an energy which corresponds to the standard or the bond energy of bromines. And here also we have half as in chlorine, so we have to multiply by 1.5 because it is given as negative value. So we have to multiply by negative half in order to make it positive. The bond energy that to break a bond, it must be positive. So now we have bromine in gaseous state. Now we can ionize each atom using the ionization energy for potassium to get the gaseous ionic potassium, and we provide also the electronic affinity of bromine, which gives the anionic species. Now we can form the solid crystalline, here it is, using the standard or the lattice energy, here it is. Now we can calculate the standard enthalpy of formation of KBr from this Born-Haber cycle. So we apply here the same thing, the Hess law for the standard enthalpy of formation of KBr, or the standard enthalpy of reaction is the same thing, which is equal to the sum of all these energy that are involved. So here we have the sublimation energy plus the vaporization energy minus the bond energy in bromine plus the ionization energy of potassium plus the electron affinity of bromine plus the energy lattice . Now all these values are given, the sublimation energy, vaporization energy, and the bond energy of bromine and the energy lattice, that are all here. Now we just have to plug each value in this equation. And which gives a value of negative 373.5 kilojoules per mole. So here is the energy lattice, or the standard enthalpy of formation of KBr, from that is obtained from the Born-Haber cycle using the Hess law.